Hey, hey people, Five Aces here, and put up your blast shields because we're about to witness another explosive 1v1. And you're right, it's Tiberium Thursday, we are back to the roots, we're in Tiberian Dawn again. And spawning in the top left, introducing Lorrydriver. He's taking a vacation from Red Alert, and he's taking he's chosen the Tiberium infested fields of Dead in Motion 2, yeah, that's what the map is called, for his vacation stay here. And his opponent is none other than Anjew, spawning in the traditional colors of GDI. And Anjew is a long-standing member of the Tiberian Dawn community. He's been playing it since the dawn of time, I guess, way before I came into the community. Regardless, we're gonna have ourselves a really interesting 1v1, because this is the Master versus the Disciple. We're having Lorrydriver, who is fairly new to Tiberian Dawn, but Lorrydriver is someone who doesn't hold himself up with like cute build orders or early harassment or like micro tricks. He's someone who just plays to win, and he's someone who chooses the most efficient path and uses that most efficient path pretty much every single time. He does that in Red Alert, so he's as much of a meta gamer as it gets, and he does that in Tiberian Dawn as well, which he just started playing recently. But even playing against the old dogs, he can teach them some new tricks. And Anjew is going for the greediest build possible. He's going straight up move out to the blue Tiberium, and then transitioning into an early war factory for getting the maximum amount of harvesters. This is going to be met with some resistance though, because Lorrydriver has moved out after his initial Tiberium refinery, and he's aggressively taking the middle. That's what he loves to do in Red Alert as well, aggressively claiming positions, claiming his staking his claims. That's what I was trying to get at. Yeah, and being like, that's my territory now. I'm expecting to see some base defense spam, which is not all that strong in Tiberian Dawn, because they have a crazy build time. Like, unlike Red Alert, they are still fairly cheap, like guard towers and turrets are still fairly cheap, but they are so much less time efficient. I think a single guard tower costs you 22 seconds to build, and a turret like 24. We're having the first scout V out for Anjew. Probably going to scout, yep, immediately scouting into base defense. That's something you don't want to see at your vacation home here. So he's having none of this. He's trying to trade it out with the minigunners, but... oh, turret coming online. Probably spelling the end of the Humvee, yep. Pretty bad to lose your early scout vehicle. Lorry focusing the husks, not knowing that they don't do much in Tiberian Dawn. But yeah, blue tip is going to give you so much of an income spike. So we're having two for two harvesters, still fairly even. Another Humvee. This is not the response I was expecting. Like, Humvees can't get much done here. They can maybe snipe off one or two rocket soldiers, then they're gonna go down. What I would really love to see, seeing as Anjew has already built a barracks, is an early APC drop coupled with like four or five rocket soldiers to take out harvesters. This would be the smartest call, I believe. At least this is forcing a response, so Lorrydriver is moving out. You immediately see him move over his shift over his rally points. And the track bazookas of the rocket soldiers. So much range. Yep, taking down the Humvee just as expected. Okay, so let me elaborate on the metagame right now. It has been found out by trying and testing through sheer trial and error that Nod is a bit imbalanced right now, because they can go for a very cheap and efficient unit composition, as we're hanging a guard tower here. So they all only need to tech to a comm center, and all they need to do is spam artillery and infantry. The reason for that being artillery is crazily efficient in terms of, like, they are frail. Don't get me wrong, they die easily, but the artillery is so damage efficient. They do so much damage in Tiberian Dawn. They're also way more mobile. And on the other hand, and infantry is hard to counter with GDI, because GDI doesn't have like those real hard counters. MRLS kind of work, but they are too expensive. They cost like twice as much as in artillery. And we're having Lorrydriver learned the hard way that the guard towers do spread damage here. They don't just do... oh, by the way, the turret nozzle, like, the turret offset is wrong. It just occurred to me here. Recon bike transition out for Lorrydriver, very good. And we're having a... okay, this guard tower seems fine, but this turret seems fine, but the other one that just went down, but the other one from Lorrydriver, it had a like a falsely set offset of the turret. Did you see it? Like the shot was not coming out of the turret itself, but from the top of the turret. So here we're seeing an APC, just what the doctor ordered. That's right, that's exactly what he needed here. Anjew raiding the eco. Lorrydriver selling out. But it's a refinery for refinery. Oh, this comm center is very ill-fated. I would have placed it like here. Instead, it goes down immediately without accomplishing much. And all that Anjew has are a couple minigunners now. He's gonna be in low power mode, I expect. Yeah. Low power inbound. The MCV is not deployed. Please deploy. Please. So this is looking bad for Anjew at this point in time. How can he recover? Well, at least he has shunned away the infantry. And Lorrydriver is not someone who is known for giving up. Here we have the... Lorrydriver is going to keep up the pressure. He's not going to sit back and relax on his laurels. Instead, he's going to aggressively move in again. Very good, very good. Anjew taking out another harvester. That's what he needed here. And you can see, like, the micro was a bit lackluster. So the minigunners, if Lorrydriver had paid full attention, the minigunners could have focused down the rocket soldiers and probably could have saved the harvester in time. But hey, that's life. And yeah, that's Lorrydriver being kicked down to one harvester. The being kicked back into the economical stone age. Meanwhile, Anjew is on four harvesters, so all he needs now is mass production. I would not suggest APCs. APCs are not the best call here. Not very great versus versus infantry. And unlike in Red Alert, Tiberian Dawn, the APCs don't have much armor. They're mostly used for mobility purposes, and they're also anti-air, obviously. Which is a big difference from Red Alert. We're having double barracks out for Anjew. That's a good call. I like what he's doing here. He is just getting mass up, because he's got the eco. Look at this. Lorrydriver being completely broke. He had to rebuild his harvesters. Thing is, Lorrydriver has got the middle and he's mining blue Tiberium. So let's see how the income graphs spike here. You see, that was with Anjew having both refineries and the blue Tiberium. He was spiking like crazy. But now he's dipping off again. I don't like this composition. The APCs are just way too fragile to go into guard towers. And the infantry is not that great either. We're having another pack up with an APC, probably going for another eco raid. If he can keep up the harvester snipes, Anjew's in a good position. I mean, look at this. Lorrydriver has recovered. Like, there was no aggression, so he was able to go into four harvesters and get a communication center up at the same time and spam more base defenses as well. But that's the harvester being attacked again. Passing arrows, and oh my god, he's being blocked by his own people. That was really, really unfortunate for Lorrydriver. His infantry blocked off the path for his harvester, and the other harvester that goes to the blue tip is also being attacked. Can he escape? He's got the road advantage. Oh no, but the track bazookas. Bazookas tracking for too long. First artillery out, and now look at what this bad boy does. Costs 600. Costs as much as an APC. Look at what this does to a weapons factory. If it hits properly, it just demolishes buildings. Buildings, infantry, and even heavy armor. Like, there is not much of a damage penalty of harvesters versus of artilleries versus like harvesters. If they take a direct hit, everything dies. And yeah, that forces a sellout of the weapons factory just off of one artillery. Look at this defensive spam here. Really annoying. Like, that's a cumulative 5 minutes invested into build time for guard towers and turrets. And this lone artillery can be so annoying here. Just, yeah, pressuring the Tiberium refinery. Anjew has got the cash. Lorry is broke, but what can Anjew do? He's mass producing from two barracks, but he doesn't have a weapons factory. And as long as the pressure is being kept up here, this camouflage artillery that just hides behind a tree, it's like a mirage artillery, is not gonna get dented. We have another drop here. Light tank transition from Lorry. I'm not sure about that. That's a rifle drop. That's not gonna do the damage that he needs. Definitely not happening. So much infantry and the artillery. And artillery just murders. Artillery murders infantry. Despite their owner being guard towers, they're not good versus infantry, but they force them to go prone. Look at this. The shots don't come from the turret itself. Oh, that's a very ill-placed refiner, weapons factory. Immediately taken under fire again by the artillery. Advanced guard tower is out, probably pushing him back. Yeah, Lorry's artillery finally dying to the AoE. And that's the comm center being under pressure here. If it goes down, then Anjew has got a shot at recovering. There's one more artillery. You can deal with one artillery, but you can't deal with the spam. You can't deal with continuously pumping out artilleries, because they're just so cost efficient. One $600 artillery has forced a sellout on a weapons factory and on a Tiberian refinery. And this lonesome artillery is probably gonna spell the end of the guard tower. Look at how accurate they are. Look at how much damage they do. It's ridiculous. Yeah, five shells. Killed an advanced guard tower, and the advanced guard towers cost like 1200? 1200, I believe. Don't quote me on that. I don't know the price tags. Not a Tiberian Dawn player. What Anjew really needs here is an airstrike. This is airstrike bait. Recon buggy transition, huh? I'm wondering what is Lorry doing with this. Oh, he's intercepting a lone combat squad. The rapid response team cleaning up house here, cleaning shop. Another advanced guard tower, but it's not gonna stand up to so much fire. Especially the artillery. It's just gonna blast it sky high. There is an MRLS out, finally. And it's taking pot shots at the artillery. Now you might think, well, MRLS sure seem like a hard counter. Like, in theory, they are a hard counter to artilleries. The problem is, MRLS cost twice as much as an artillery and have way, way less damage, especially versus infantry. So they have more damage spread, but less actual damage. So you can't keep up trading. It's just not worth it, because like, if you lose one of those rocket launchers, it's twice the amount of cash. Like, one rocket launcher for two artilleries is still almost in the favor of a Nod player. Finally, the defensive structure spam is being cleaned up here. That's exactly what Anjew needs to finally start applying pressure here. But more and more defensive structures being pumped out. Well, that was a short-lived turret. The decay of the turret. It's very funny, like 10 seconds. That's a very expensive push. Oh no, this can be countered by a couple minigas. But the airstrike is coming in. Can it get the artillery in time before major damage is being inflicted? Yes! Okay, a harvester is going down, so Lorrydriver down to 3 harvesters. But still, he's got the blue tape and so much artillery spam coming in from all sides and angles. And how do you respond as a GDI player? If you split up your forces, you're probably going to lose, squad for squad, you're gonna lose. So you need an overpowering force, and that's something you can't afford, or barely can afford. Yep. So Anjew is being under pressure here. And yeah, MRLS, like, that's 4 MRLS, that's 5,000 in cash. And still not that great versus infantry. Almost as good as one artillery. Right? And 3 more artilleries waiting. So all that Lorry really needs to do here is camp the flanks here. Target the refineries with his artilleries. He has it scouted, yes. All he needs to do is target all the refineries. And then it's golden. And this is such an expensive composition here. If those rocket launchers go down, it's probably GG. And already the first shell's landing close to the... very close to the MRLS, and that's such a clump. One airstrike and it's game over. This MRLS, not in a good spot. 2 more MRLS go down. The infantry chasing away the rocket launchers. 2 more remaining. That is a devastating blow here. Did you see how just one artillery and a couple riflemen were able to push back this expensive composition? And now we have three artilleries target firing the advanced guard towers and defensive structures. The infantry coming in and targeting the refineries. This is not looking good for Anjew. The artillery, yeah, that's just an attack move. But still, look at the damage that the artillery does. It even kills harvesters reliably. So all the eco is down here for Anjew. Probably in a couple seconds he's not gonna have a refinery anymore. This is looking very bleak at that point. More and more artillery streaming in. He was not able to deny the comm center a second time. Weapons factory going down. Harvester under pressure here, probably going down. The spread damage, not enough. An airstrike coming in, killing one of the... yep. K- killing one of the rocket launchers. It doesn't matter at this point. There are no refineries left. Three harvesters, no refs. Not a good ratio if you're asking me. And those two MRLS are completely unprotected, trying to go on into the flanks. There is a helicopter for Lorrydriver, and that is going to spell GG because there is no discernible anti-air at the point in time and no way of recovering here. He's desperately trying to get out of refinery. The advanced guard tower going down to artillery spam. Yes, too much pressure. However, this is game one. There is a game two, and game two is going to be on a more open map. It was played on a more open map, I believe. Rocket Soldier frozen in time. Can't believe what has happened. Anjew just selling out everything. He has the comms error. He's probably got one more airstrike in him, and then that's it. Defensive structures being cleaned up by the ridiculously accurate artilleries. 4, 5, 6, 7 artillery shells to kill a guard tower. Or a turret, I should say. Oh, and the airstrike completely whiffs because of the repositioning from the artilleries. Yeah. 3 more artilleries fall to an advanced guard tower. There's a refinery and 4 harvesters, but I just don't think it's enough. No production facilities whatsoever for Anjew. Oh my lord, this is so brutal to watch. There's more and more artillery spam, just targeting the advanced guard tower. And probably taking down the comm center, kicking into low power. Minigunners dying, no production facilities, and you're calling the GG. That's it for game one, ladies and gentlemen, but we have ourselves a game two at hand. Unfortunately, there is no such a thing as game three. It got lost in the void of the space-time continuum, or it has never been played. I'm not sure which. Either of those will suffice. Let's check the earnings. In terms of earnings, like, Anjew was completely okay. How did he trade? Not very well. The reason for that being the cheap artilleries. They are so spammable. Yeah, they cost you like a month worth of pocket money. That's what the artilleries cost you. Way too cheap for what they do right now. And Lorrydriver, being the meta gamer that he is, finding the imbalances and just, yeah, using them to his advantage. So one thing that I would have really liked to see out of Anjew would have been an Orca, because there was no dedicated anti-air. At least the rocket soldiers can be moved around and played around by Orcas because they're really mobile, and Orcas do snack artilleries, so they're like a soft counter. At least they would have forced Lorrydriver into building less turrets and guard towers and more SAM sites. If anything, that's a slight victory. So I would have liked to see at least one Orca, also for line of sight for the MRLS, so he knows what he's dealing with. Anyway, that's it for game one. I'll see you in game two.
Battle control terminated.
And we're back in game two, and this is in one of my favorite 1v1 maps. Let's talk about the players first. Anjew, as same as before, he has decided to make the GDI build work, and Lorrydriver is committing himself to artillery spam. He's trading his soul for some artillery spam. This is Pirates and Emperors, I believe. Yep, one of my favorite 1v1 maps in Tiberian Dawn. It's fairly open, but your bases are still protected. There are those ridges or those, like, it's in the top side it's cliffs, on the southern side it's a small creek. But they allow you to play around with artillery and MRLS. Allow for some nice tactical play. Also, it's got blue Tiberium trees. It's not perfectly balanced though. And the reason being that the blue Tiberium tree on the top side has only 6 cells for growth. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the one on the bottom side is placed a tile higher. So it has 9 cells for growth. So technically, if you're taking this expansion, if it goes into the late game, then the bottom spawn is at an advantage. But as we have learned before and tried and tested time and again, yeah, Tiberian Dawn matches rarely ever go into the late game. We're having the early factory for Anjew again. This time it's going to be an airstrip build for Lorry, so probably a recon bike rush. Let's see. Recon bikes, by the way, are also really powerful, but you have your ways of dealing with them or playing around them. You have your APCs, force you to build a barracks, mind you, but yeah, APCs are fairly reliably countering like Recon bikes. This is probably going to be an early harvest drought for Anjew. Yep. And we're having the Recon bike spam. Like, on a map like this, Recons are still deadly, but they take their time to arrive, so you have like an extra 15 seconds to get maybe an APC out. And here we see the barracks for Anjew, so he's probably not gonna dilly-dally around with rushing those APCs. There's gonna be, that's, judging from how fast this is building, this is an APC. Costs you only 550 in Tiberian Dawn, I believe. And also, no, that's a Humvee, 400. And also we're having a couple, is that minigunners? Yeah, minigunner on hold. Due to there not being any cash whatsoever. Three recon bikes, so at least this is gonna get scouted. Like, three recon bikes, I think, take down a harvester in two or three volleys. Not entirely sure. By the way, I'm loving the desert tile set, which is a leftover from the original Tiberian Dawn. I'm loving those desert-themed maps. Looking gorgeous, this creek here. Okay, this must be like some... This is really weird, this must be like some submerged... the fountain of this, or the point of origin of this creek is kind of odd, because it's on the high ground, and the water must come from somewhere, right? But anyway, let's not concern ourselves with geography too much. Let's focus on the recon bike rush at hand. It has been scouted by the Humvee, and so I'm expecting an APC to come out really, really soon. Lorry is maybe hesitating too much. If he had went in earlier... Oh, wow. Humvees are not good versus... There's a guard tower at least. Guard tower is at least gonna shun them away. He can get the harvester, but he decides to bail out. Probably a bit too early. He didn't have to bail out here. Yeah. Humvees are really expensive, cost almost as much as a recon bike, and just don't trade very well. Probably he can get the 1v1, 1v1 here. Yep. There we go. One more recon bike remaining, so this rush has been dealt with accordingly. What I would have really liked to see from Lorry is him going deeper. That's what makes the bike so deadly, is that they're really mobile and they can hit and run. He could have gone for the harvester and just ran out of the range of the guard tower. And this would have forced Anjew into building a second guard tower and delayed his economy and also sniped the harvester. And thus the death spiral would have begun. Instead, we're having an early comm center, and I'm expecting nothing other than artilleries from this point on. Lorrydriver has tried the taste, and he has decided that he likes it. So let's see, what is this gonna be? Production? No light tanks! Okay, he's opting for a more mobile composition. Well, that's fair enough. We're having another APC, but we've seen that the APCs are just not worth it in a composition like this. Oh, engineers for Lorry. He's taking the derricks. He's not a Tiberian Dawn player. He doesn't know that Tiberian Dawn players don't do that. It's like it's like wearing white tennis socks to your business outfits. It's just a no-go. That's a no-no. You don't do it. The engineer is sneaking by Ali's house and the camel trader. Oh, while we're at it, okay, we're seeing infantry spam, defensive infantry spam from Anjew. And he's also gotten the comm center up. So what's it gonna be? Probably a power plant. Maybe double war factory, maybe double barracks. So okay, we're having two derricks for Lorrydriver, but it's not that significant. Lorry has been moving his MCV, so this entire base is completely unprotected. Medium tank transition for Anjew, that's what I like to see. Double war factory medium tanks. So against this, the artilleries are not going to be that efficient anymore. There's a small little push, but enough infantry to deter it. And let's check this. Camel trader, Ali's house, trader Ted. Wow, like those two are going to put each other out of business. They have put each other out of business, I guess. Presto John's house. There's another trader Ted, like this guy's running an empire. Abdul's house. Ted, what the fuck? Whoa, 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 Ted. That's like, Ted is having a monopoly here. Only, the camel trader is the only one he hasn't put out of business yet. And Salah's house, like five customers and 6 stores. That's an unhealthy ratio. Yeah, but Anjew has taken a page out of the book from Lorrydriver, and he is having defensive spam himself. So this is not going to happen. We're having another engagement here. Medium tanks can reliably push this back. Medium tanks are what is needed here, because they are really, really durable. And they can go in. They can just go in, deal with the artillery, deal with the light tanks, and they can fire on the move. Yeah, chasing down the artillery. 2 shots are enough to kill artillery. That's what I like to see here. So, Anjew has redeployed aggressively. He's feeling very confident here. That's probably a bad place to fight for the medium tanks. Running into a 5 stack of rocket soldiers is never advisable. Ooh, and look at those! If you take a direct hit with a medium tank, even medium tanks suffer from like dying to artillery. This little force is probably just preventing a move out with the MCV. I don't see him pushing through. Guard tower, a couple turrets. But so many medium tanks coming out for Anjew. And honestly, that's the smartest call he can make at this point in time. Lorrydriver is redeploying a 3rd time, aggressively claiming his stakes. That's what he likes to do. It's what I said previously in the earlier card, in the earlier game. He likes moving out his MCVs, moving them around, and spreading his base out. So just claiming territories. Yep. He's playing the old Monopoly game here. Claiming what is his, what is rightfully his. Mass artillery transition out for Lorrydriver. Look at how fast they build. This is so ridiculous. Let's look at the build timer. Is it like 15 seconds? Yeah. 15 seconds for an artillery. And an MRLS takes you almost twice as much. MRLS takes you like, what? 28 seconds? Don't quote me. I'm not very reliable when it comes to those stats in Tiberian Dawn. I played myself, but not religiously so. That's a huge force that's moving out for Lorrydriver, but it's single file formation. So this can get caught off guard really easily. 4 medium tanks, is it enough to pierce through the armor here? The artillery are wasting their shots onto the medium tanks, and if the medium tanks are moving, that's okay. Yeah, we're having so many dead artilleries here. More and more medium tanks. There is an airstrike. Is it gonna hit? It's gonna hit hard, isn't it? Yeah, not that hard. No, gets 2 medium tanks. And just too much infantry and artillery to deal with. Oh my lord. What a loss here for Anjew. Anjew getting completely cleaned up here. Yeah, that's Lorry cleaning shop. His mass infantry artillery build paying off big dividends. There's a flank by the southern forces that were camping the ore field previously. 5 more minigunners. And look at this. Nothing in this composition can deal with infantry reliably. Medium tanks can get crushes in, but if they're spread out, it's just too much. So again, this forces Anjew into a bad engagement. Even though he can, like, this is not enough armor. He can deal with the medium tanks and kill the artilleries at his leisure. There is artillery coming in and trying to kill out the guard towers, kill the guard towers. Yeah, good stuff. Keep it up, that's what we like to see. The repair facility a bit aggressive here. 4 more medium tanks. Just trying to deal with the artilleries and trying to get crushes in. Mostly working. Mostly functional here. The artillery fire. You can't even tell where it's coming from anymore. Like, so many artilleries. An endless stream coming out. More and more closing in from the west. That's the reinforcements. It's round 2 of the tower defense. Tower defense squad for Anjew. There's an iron cannon. Okay. So if he can hold this, he's got the tactical advantage by being able to snipe a huge blob of armor and infantry. It's like, not a really hard counter because it's so costly and it takes so long, but yeah. What you gonna do, buddy? What you gonna do when the artillery infantry blob moves into your barracks, into your conyard? He's trying to get some eco snipes, he's trying to find the harvesters, but his conyard is in peril. That's the conyard, that's his only conyard, by the way. Trying to redeploy, it's too late. Too much artillery fire. A hail of steel just completely evaporating the conyard. And That's probably not necessarily already game for Anjew, but he's in a really tight spot now. He's got two weapons factories, he's got the repair facility, but it's not really worth it rebuilding the conyard. That's the thing here. A conyard in Tiberian Dawn costs you 4,000. That's like the price of 5 medium tanks, right? So I would rather have 5 medium tanks than a conyard that is or that has to pay off. So we're having mass minigunners, mass medium tanks. An interesting call here. What I'm guessing that Anjew is trying to do here is trying to get some run bys. But if Lorrydriver keeps up the pressure, he's got so much eco. Look at this. He's got saturation here. He's got a big blob of army here that just needs to move into the advanced comp center. One of the medium tanks gets sniped. 5 more remaining. Oh. Getting one crush. Getting at least one artillery run over. Okay, so here this is starting to show one of the glaring weaknesses of this build. Artilleries are not very mobile. They're not good at defending. They're good at attacking. But at defending versus mobile forces, yeah, not so much. So 5 medium tanks in the eco lines. This is exactly what Anjew needs to do here. And he's splitting them up. That's such a smart call. 2 on the harvesters. 3 on the comm center. If the comm center goes down, that's a huge setback. Yep, it's being sold, but regardless, comm center is out of the picture for some time. 2 more medium tanks focusing down the harvesters. That is such good play by Anjew. He's applying pressure on multiple fronts, getting one more harvester down. That's 2 down, comm center down. 3rd harvester being under pressure. Is he gonna focus? No. Not focusing it down in time, but yeah, they're too slow to respond, as you can see here. Yeah, one more harvester going down, biting the dust. So that's one harvester left on this flank. And here we have 2, 3. So he's on 4 harvesters. One of the oil derricks got raided. The artillery is trying to apply some pressure here. This harvester is going on full on I do whatever I want mode. Fuck the police. More and more minigunners, medium tanks. A very simple composition, but super effective in this case. In this very specific fringe case. That's exactly what he's needing here. Does he have an airstrike up? Very shortly, yeah, and the iron cannon. Oh, the iron cannon is up. So we're seeing the airstrike here. We're seeing some kung fu minigunners. Everybody goes kung fu fighting. And the airstrike coming in, blasting away some of the artillery. Also, more importantly, some of the rocket soldiers went down. So Anjew has the pushing power necessary to get through here. He's trying to get down the production facilities. Such a smart call. No more infantry for some. Oh! Ion strike onto the blob. He can get the airstrip. Yeah, that's the most important target here. One of the airstrips going down, so artillery spam only off of one airstrip now. A second harvester going down. This is exactly what Anjew needs to do. Looking very good for him at this point in time. The MCV redeploying. Here we have a very ballsy harvester. Wow! That harvester went on a rampage, man. Slampage. The Tiberium refinery is all that remains. In the middle we have another comm center and the Tiberium refinery. Medium tanks, look at this. Medium tanks just running into the artillery. Relentlessly going for the airstrip. And that's exactly the targets he needs to focus down. Perfect play for Anjew. That's the recipe. That's the spirit here. And the light tanks were just not mobile enough. I mean, they're more mobile than medium tanks, but he was hard pressured into defending with them instead of attacking. And they're like, in Tiberian Dawn, vehicles are really sturdy and really mobile. So the defender is always going to be at a disadvantage if the base is spread out. Oh, medium tanks going back in, trying to go for some more blood and probably getting the tip ref in the process. No repairs coming out for Lorry. There goes the tip ref. And Lorry desperately trying to cling on. He's got a hand of knot here. He's got the conyards. He's probably trying to get his eco back up. But 2 barracks are all that remains in terms of production. There are more and more medium tanks being pumped out. No more guard tower reinforcement as well. That's a big deal. Because the guard tower spam was all that kept the infantry from running in and killing the base. And this simple yet effective combination here for Anjew. Really good target fire as well. He didn't waste his minigunners trying to go in first. Instead, he's exhibiting how to force fire and how to focus fire with your units. You can see the minigunners being in the back and trying to kill the rocket soldiers. Meanwhile, the medium tanks are just staying here, soaking up damage and killing whatever is necessary. Killing harvesters, killing power plants. Advanced power plant going down. Still no low power for Lori. She's got an airstrike up. The airstrike would be so deadly. He needs to pull the trigger. Too late. It's too late. He pulled the trigger, but it was a bit too late. The airstrike being slightly off center. Not getting much done. Refinery remaining here. Desperate guard tower spam, but it's not red alert. You're not gonna have a pillbox every 8 seconds. No, sir. It's just not happening. And if Anjew goes for the barracks, goes for the conyard, there is nothing that Lorrydriver can do to come back. He's probably floating at this point in time, yeah. 4k almost. Airstrip being built back up. And these, yeah, man. Beautiful. Anjew immediately analyzing the situation and knowing that there is nothing here guarding the main base. He can take out the power plants and the harvester for free. Even splitting them up. Two of the tanks going for the power plants, one going on harvester hunt. On, that's grenadiers. Finally, we're seeing grenadiers. Fairly good versus buildings, and also, like, unlike in Red Alert, grenadiers are good. They don't explode all that much, and they do a lot of AoE damage. Especially, like, versus buildings, infantry. Still no hard counter to infantry. Yeah, that's it. I would have to say that's it. So, finally, for the first time, Anjew has found the perfect recipe here. So here we're seeing the spread damage from the grenadiers. Ooh, once those grenades start hitting, it's GG. So many rocket soldiers, but GG being called for Lorrydriver. And Anjew has played it perfectly in game 2. He has found the right recipe, a mobile composition that tries and pressure instead of just defending. That's Tiberian Dawn, much more than Red Alert, is a game where you need to apply constant pressure to your opponent. And that was a really good game, really fun to observe and to cast. Thanks to Lorry for posting these. These were posted by Lorry, so nice move by him to also post the games where he's lost. Unfortunately, there is no game 3. I would wish there were, but there isn't. And Anjew just barely trading cost efficiently because, again, artilleries are so cheap. But he has found a workaround this time. Two factory, medium tank spam, and infantry. Just catching the harvesters out of position, catching the conyard out of position, catching production structures that were completely undefended. And this is one of the advantages of TD over the Red Alert mod. Usually no one is going to go for a second MCV because it's highly suicidal in a 1v1 to rush a structure that costs you 4,000 credits. And doesn't provide you with much more in terms of armed forces. So yeah, there's not going to be much defensive spam, or at least there's only going to be defensive spam where the conyard is deployed. And if you recognize that there is a base where there's no conyard, then you can just go in because you know that there are no base defenses. So anyway, that was a really fun and really active, action-packed 1v1, two games in a row. That's it for this week. I'll see you guys next time. Five Aces out. Battle control.